Who saw this coming at half-time? What an afternoon for Wasps.
I know you like to keep a poker face during the game, but Haskell was saying afterwards that he'd never seen you smile as much.
They've surged into the quarterfinals. They've topped the pool.
How could you not smile after that performance?
Goodness me.
Nobody gave us a chance to get up the group, so, you know, I was absolutely over the moon for all the players, really.
How have you managed to come through that pool full of champions in the way that you have, with the style that you have?
I thought it was a great draw for us. Nobody, you know, expected us to do anything, so we had a no-lose situation. And we ended up having two outstanding performances in the first two games, which really put us in a position of confidence, really. And then every game became a massive game. And for whatever reason, we've certainly saved our best performances for Europe.
Which was your favourite game? Which was the game which, if you were saying, this is the way I want our team to play, would you point someone towards?
Well, certainly the last game, because it was over. I know, we were through. Pretty nervous going into that game. Because,
were you?
Yeah, I think, you know, Leinster are a good side.
OK, are we ready to go?
If we give them space and give them time, they could have caused us problems.
You know, but if we lose, we're out. It's simple. Keep it simple.
To really kick on like we did sort of the last 30 minutes was really pleasing, because we failed to do that for most of the year. I think any of the fans that follow us week in, week out know we like to win games three times and lose it twice. We don't get many supporters leaving with 5 minutes to go watching Wasps.
It was only 5 years ago that we were literally 80 minutes away from relegation and potential administration. We did just about enough to stay up and then set ourselves on a little bit of a journey, pick us up to Coventry, where things have been much, much better.
For nigh on 20 years without a place to call their own, not anymore. This is home.
I'm not an emotional man, but the first game at the Rico, I felt pretty emotional then. You can't help but have a little lump in your throat.
Let's listen to the big hello.
The week has been hugely successful. With the financial security, it has allowed me to bring in some quality players, but we're still in the same facilities at this moment in time, and things are still a little bit tough.
Have you got one of the porter cabins that leaks?
I certainly ain't got no leaks in my porter cabin, but I got no eating either. So you know, but you know, we're not going to complain. I think, you know, that it does the job.
They've got some room here. Gopper, equalising try.
How did Dye sell this place to you? What are the buttons that he needs to press for somebody like Jimmy Gopper to go, that sounds like a good idea?
Well, I suppose it's first and foremost, it's the way, the Wasps way, and they play. They like to play a fast game, they like to run with the ball. I knew Wasps was a team like that, and when Dye said, you know, that's the way he wants to go forward as well, it got me really excited. And, you know, you just got to look to the guys on the team sheet, you know, and then when he said, you know, guys are like George Smith are coming in, it just made it really exciting. And, yeah, it was too good to turn down.
Number 5 for Frank Halai. It's around half dozen for Wasps.
When Dye's smiling, the club's smiling, I guess. So if we can keep smiles on his face, then I think we're all in for an easier time.
Dye's mob have done a job.
It's a relentless season, isn't it?
Yeah, and to be honest, we're struggling with it a little bit, Nick. I think if you look at our form this season, we're not used to competing at two sort of levels, really. And the biggest thing that we need now is continuity. We need continuity of the playing squad and the staff. And I think we need to be, over the next couple of seasons, a consistent top 16. And, you know, keep on pushing for top 4, keep on pushing for silverware, but we've got to be that consistent team in the top 6.